Hello everybody, welcome back to a brand new video, and today it's a massive one. We've got the Xtreme Outlaw series coming to Quoin for the first time, or the second time actually, sorry. And this is their season opener for 2024, so this is going to be an exciting video. I hope you guys enjoy it, and yeah, that's it. Let's get to Quoin. This is our final time here for the season, unfortunately. But Eli Holden's here, so we're going to give him a certificate here since we're thinking about it. Just had a meeting with the Xtreme social, the Xtreme guys, asking if there's a photographer meeting, and apparently there's not. They're not sure if there will be. But I don't know why, because they did things. This is different than last year, from what I remember. So I don't know. But yeah, let's go get the show on the road here in a little bit. Now that I've done my rounds, it's time to make my rounds outside, and I see the champ's car out there. I can see it. I don't know if you guys can, but I can.
The building up front here by the registration table. We'll let you right back in to show us that you got your pit pass. We need everybody to exit the building up here by the registration table.
Okay, so I'm just doing a head count for all the midgets, and it's 35 so far. I don't know who else. I haven't walked around the full pit area yet, but pretty much the majority of them are outside. Majority of them. So, there's a high limit truck over there. That's interesting. Oh. There's Jade over there. Well, there's a champ for you. I don't know if you guys saw her or not. I don't know if the camera picked her up that much, but. But, yeah, there's about 35 midgets, I'd say, roughly. I haven't found any more yet. Keith Koontz has got 7 of them. I think I've mentioned that already. Mounts, I think it's got right around 5 or 6. Then there's some small budget teams here too. But I don't know. It's only 1:15. So we still got a couple hours. We still got a few hours for hot laps yet to even begin. Midgets, I think, are gonna have their qualifying. Now, they're gonna have their engine heat first. Crap, I gotta look at the damn thing. I gotta look at the schedule of events for tonight. So that way I can figure out where to go and where to be. But, yeah. And to be honest, you don't see that every day. You don't see a big rig like that very often. Only the big guys have those. So, yeah, let's get back inside and, show you guys around what's going on. This is a look inside, you guys. I don't know if it, I don't know if my camera can pick it up, but this is all the cars that are pitted inside.
Did I talk to me?
Okay, I have no clue what they're doing, but I guess we're just testing that out. Because apparently, I guess they're going to do driver introductions, I guess. I don't know what they're doing there. They just started blowing that up earlier. And I was on the phone with my mom and I looked at it and I'm like, what is it? What are they doing? But I don't know. I'm just going to keep on going and see what happens. So, guys, you just saw a little bit from the Xtreme meeting. I'll probably post more tomorrow. Oh, shit. I'm in the way. I'm in the way as always. Well, before I was...
When I take it off...
Before I was completely and utterly interrupted. We got 46 midgets here, and you guys saw a little bit from the driver's meeting there from Xtreme, but I'll probably film it tomorrow for you guys for the video. So, we got 46 midgets here. Majority of them are mounts and KKM, I think. This KKM's got 7 right there. I think mounts got... Oh, poo. I think they got probably somewhere in the region of 5 or 6. I'd love to say, so... But for KKM, they got Reimer, McIntosh, Evdissian, Torgerson, Drocksky, somebody else. I can't remember off the top of my head. And for mounts, I have no idea. So, but it's going to be a good night tonight. We just got out of the driver's meeting for that. I went ahead and kind of stayed for that to kind of see what the heck they were doing since I'm covering the Xtreme Outlaw series this weekend, too. So... It's gonna be a pretty good weekend for Xtreme for sure, bringing out 46 cars, and it's gonna be a good weekend for us here at Sneed Motorsports, so to bring in a big series like this into the area, it's pretty freaking sweet, so, and especially for me, this is the third race of the year, and we're already covering a national series in the third race of the year, so it's pretty fun. Anyways, when I see you again, it'll be out on the track. Final time we'll be walking on the infield of this place until next year or at some point. No idea. But we're gonna get the show on the road here in just a minute. And qualifying, all that stuff is done. I'm actually gonna fit you outside of the track for the heat races. See if I can get any good stuff there, and then come back in during please attempt to try to come back in during the midgets last chance showdown. And while I'm at it, I'm also gonna get a dinner break while I'm at it. While I'm out, so could do things a little differently.
So shooting in the infield
the whole time. That's the staging belt. That's the staging horn for Xtreme and midgets, but yeah. Okay, we just finished up heat races. I know I'm not getting any footage. I know. It's just, I just don't have much time to do it. I'm focusing more on the picture aspect of things. So, just give you guys an update. We've had a few incidents. Jade got caught up in something earlier, but now she should be back out here soon. But she'll be in a LCS, as Xtreme would call it. But we got a couple of cars staging. So you did your wreck it?
Yeah. It wasn't too bad. I'd say maybe the feature got a couple more laps and so we'll be alright.
But guys, I'm gonna tell you what. Tonight's been good so far. I'm impressed with everything, how everything's going right now. Really, it's been fun so far. You guys are going to see the full midget feature as well. I'm going to film all of it. And so that way you guys have something to watch. I know I didn't get much stuff. And I apologize. I'm going to try to do that for night two later on in the video. But it's just kind of hard for me to do that. I'm kind of running around like a chicken with its head cut off, running around past the K-Cam trailers and all that. So, but yeah. I promise you guys, I'll give you guys some footage of the Xtreme Outlaw feature, as well as the other features, so you guys have something to watch in this video. It's getting part of the video. But then, after that, you guys are going to see some... I'm going to try to do some behind-the-scenes stuff for tomorrow. Maybe film some out here. Maybe some of the cars, get some good shots of the cars, maybe. That's kind of what I'm thinking. But I'm not sure. So, maybe see if I can get a couple drivers to jump in the video, maybe just once. Maybe some of those guys or somebody. So, anyways, guys, when you see me next, it'll either be after everything is done or after the feature for the Xtreme Outlaw Series Midgets.
Right now you're top five, but we got one stopped over at turn number two. It's Tyler Robbins. Josh up there. Now contact. Tim spins around. Tyler Edwards on top of the 67. Caution is out one more time.
This is the greatest thing that I have ever seen. Out of everything that's on the internet, this is the best thing that has ever existed.
Upside down.
Xtreme Outlaw Midget Series win, his fourth career win here at the Southern Illinois Center. Now the all-time winningest midget driver in this building. As T-Mez, always excited, a fan favorite no matter where he is. Fresh off a trip to New Zealand.
Well, I like to think, I used to say I'm an indoor specialist because I race sprint cars full time. Then Dave Estep hired me, and now a midget guy, you know. But I've had a lot of luck in this place, and like I said in the heat race, I would rather be lucky than good any day. We drew the front row on the redraw. Jade had a bad night. Cannon sucks. And, like, so, you know, some of my competition wasn't there, you know what I mean? So it helped. I got lucky, you know. I didn't have some of the hitters I thought I was going to be racing with. But hats off to these guys. I mean, this is, I think, the seventh or eighth night on this brand new MF1 car. We got this EA Stealth, the Ford FR9 cylinder head that my boss built from the ground up. So super pumped just to be here. I just got back from New Zealand. So I've been racing. I haven't even had a winner. So this is awesome. And if you came out to the races, thank you.
fans. Ryan starts tonight's feature action in victory lane.
From the middle of the pack, and Keaton, you led quite a few laps. You fell back to third, and then you got back to the point position and led the last half of the race. As he climbs out of his car right now, ready to celebrate. But Keaton, my man, you started off feature action tonight by parking this 3X machine in victory lane. Tell me how this win feels.
Strong.
guys, night one is wrapped up. I did have my GoPro out there with me in the infield, so I had to suffice with my phone for that one piece. Night one was actually pretty good. Went great, and we're off to night two tomorrow. I'm gonna get back to the office and get some victory lane out. Get some other stuff done. Head to bed and repeat this process tomorrow.
Five trucks and all.
A few moments later.
Back at the Quoin, guys. Second time around. And the final time for the year. At least in the regular season, anyway. And it's a beautiful day. Absolutely beautiful day out here. Okay guys, so I just got out onto the infield now. I got caught up in talking to somebody and did get the chance to film the Xtreme Outlaw series driver's meeting. I'm watching a replay from last night on the big screen here, but yeah, I didn't get to, but I do apologize for that, but you guys will see some footage later on. Of the night so far, and but honestly, last night was pretty cool, pretty good, as I said. Oh shoot, yeah, we had a flip on the front stretch at the very end. That was with Shane Cottle, and he's okay.
All of us, Thomas Spencer, are all put on a master class here on the 6 mile oval.
Last night went really good, pretty good action. We had some wrecks. We had some, pretty much a mix of everything, I'd say, so. But, speaking of Jade, she didn't have a best night. She got P14 last night after pretty much a pretty terrible feature. She started P21, I think. But hopefully she has better luck tonight, though.
Later today.
I'll be back in a minute when he's done.
Thomas Spencer.
ladies and gentlemen, it's time to get dirty with the Xtreme Outlaw Midgets here at the Southern Illinois Center. Joe B. Miller and T-Mez to set the pace. Green flag is out. Let's do it.
Yeah, first and foremost, give all the glory to God. I wouldn't be here without him, but yeah, I knew it was going to be a shootout there at the end. I seen Keith. I couldn't exactly hear him, but once they said 67, I knew Ryan had started further back, so I knew he had to have been pretty good to cut through the field. So I had imagined that there was another lane opening up, but like Keith was telling me, just don't miss the bottom because it was going to be hard to get around me. So that's all we did, just try not to miss it there at the end. I think I missed it on the first lap on the restart and then kind of got in a rhythm there. But, man, it feels refreshing. I feel like I haven't been to victory lane in a while. So it takes good teams like this and really good people behind me. There's lots of new guys here. I'm new here too, so I can't say everyone's name. But, man, everyone works really hard. And Keith gave me an amazing car all weekend and just super happy to leave here with the win. Just be able to do this for Gear Wrench and Toyota. I wouldn't be here in this position without them. So. Yeah, there's a lot of great partners that put me here. Shout out to my family watching at home. Yeah, it's amazing. It's huge. I knew we were a factor all weekend. You know, last night we just weren't dealt very good cards and had to dig ourselves out of a hole, but we still had a good piece and had good speed. But yeah, it's a big confidence booster, not only for me, but I feel like the guys are working on this thing. It motivates them. I know they like winning. So yeah, it's huge for just the whole team. So yeah, not just me. So I'm super excited for what this season's going to bring, and I'm just thankful to be in this position.
That's it for DuQuoin for the year, boys and girls. That's it. Great 3 weekends of racing for sure. Been a blast. First 3 weeks, Jeremy and Sneed have been awesome. Can't thank him enough for the opportunity. And we're going to keep it rolling. Next up, we're heading to Red Hill Raceway in Sumner, Illinois. I hope to see you guys there. See you at track near you. See you again real soon. Bye for now.